Hi everyone.
It's me, the golden goddess.
So this video is going to be two things. It's going to be some product reviews and it's going to be a makeup demo for my first trial run for my cosplay Amora the Enchantress costume. So this should be fun, doing like a two-in-one video. So the products I'm reviewing, I purchased them myself. I saw other people reviewing them and it looked amazing, so I wanted them, and that's pretty much how a lot of my reviews go. I purchased them myself because it looked good and I wanted it, and then I want to put my opinion on it. So this is the review for the HAUS Laboratories Lady Gaga's line. So here's the box. It's probably my address on it that you might have saw. Be yourself the way you see you. Love, Lady Gaga. Very cute. Very cute little box. So on the inside, I mean, who doesn't love all black packaging? I do. I love it. So I didn't get the whole line, but when you do purchase it, you get this nifty little card. Has kind of her story on the back of it. I'll probably buy the whole line, but I purchased quite a few items and they really are reasonably priced in comparison to other products out there on the market. So they're not uberly expensive, they're kind of mid-range. I only got two of the Rip Lip liners, or yeah, is it Rip Lip liner? Is it RIP lip liner? There's no dots, so I think it's Rip. And then I got like two glosses, the Le Riot glosses. I got two of those, and then I got, I think, almost all of the eyeshadows because they just looked so good to me. And those are the Glam Attack eyeshadow, liquid eyeshadows. So here's the packaging, silver and black, and look at that. It's like gradient, very lovely. I think she hit it on the nose with the packaging, just because I think that black is always a sleek and sexy packaging. It's just sleek, sexy, like, hey, I'm fancy. Okay, so the Amora the Enchantress look I'm going for, from the comics I have seen, she varies with her makeup choices. Sometimes it is a green shadow, sometimes it's smoky, sometimes there's a green lip, sometimes there's green eyebrows, sometimes there's red lips. So I'm gonna keep this kind of more traditional. I want to go with a green, kind of smoky eye, red lip, normal eyebrows. I'm not ready for the whole green eyebrows with her yet. Who knows? That's why we're demoing and playing and trying, testing out this lovely look and the products. So, here we go. I don't know what I want to do first. I think I want to put on the eyes, so I need to find the eyes. Gonna open all the shadow and review them, and this is the packaging. It's kind of got like a studded, you know, kind of like that you'd find at Hot Topic, like a studded belt top, and then it's got kind of like a diamond look on the inside. So this one is called Aphrodite. Shadow. I'm sure you guys have already seen plenty of reviews on this, but this is the Cheshire Cast review. So it feels like a liquid right now. It's pretty wet. It's pretty wet. We might save this color though out for like an inner corner highlight. That's just so pretty. This could be like a face highlighter too. And I read that yes, you can put them on your lips or on your eyes. So all over liquid shimmer powder. So I guess it really isn't just an eyeshadow, but you know. Oh, here's the color I want to use. It's like the green. It's called Dynasty. Dynasty. So yeah, this is the color I'm gonna probably use on my eyes. Gold flake in it. That's really pretty. I wonder if you have to shake them. Probably, because there's a little ball in it. Little ball, shake it up. I know what that noise sounds like. This one's called Legend. Let's see. Like, I could probably blend that one. I might. Oh, so Legend. I probably will use this color too. So Legend is like this gold. Liquid gold. Makes me feel like I'm a leprechaun now. Them by each other. Them by each other. I'm just gonna put the Aphrodite back on. There it is. We'll do a legit swatching. Because I'm a pro. I'm a pro swatcher. That's not why you guys watch this channel. Because this is a real channel. We're real. We're not pros here. Alright, so this one is the Rose Bitch. Yeah, that's right. That's what it's called. So this is like a mauve-y pink color. Very much like a mauve pink. Yeah, it's not quite purple, so. It's not quite purple. It's a little bit purple, a little bit. I guess that's why it's a mauve. That's why it's a mauve. Marvelous. Ooh. So this one is the Chained Ballerina, which I love. Love the name of this. It is the dark, the deep, the... And it does have like a gray, like graphite shimmer to it. So it's not like completely black. One more that I got. Maybe I didn't get the whole collection of liquid shadows. I don't think I did. Maybe I did. I'll let you guys know in the comments. So this one is Biker, and this is like the charcoal. I'm gonna be using these looks. These with some other looks. Like I have some other characters that I'm gonna do. So yeah, that one's very charcoal. Sparkly gray. There they are. They're swatched. Woo. Okay, so let's go in and swatch the lip liners. Don't know what color I want to do yet. Okay, so this one is the On Point. Like EN Point. So we're just
swatch it right there. You guys can see, maybe not, maybe we'll do a swatch right here. It's very, glides on really nice. Ooh, yes it does. It's like creamy and delicious. I like it. And they all have numbers too. Like this one's 03D9. It is the Rip Lip Liner. This one's in Slayer. They're just very, I mean, they all have that cool studded. That's pretty. That cool studded look. Very Gaga. So far, I approve. So far, you're winning. HAUS Laboratories. This is the lip gloss, one of them. It's called Scream. Ooh. Whoa, do you hear that pop? This Amora the Enchantress Goddess. Yeah, because this color is just not gonna do it. Okay, so this one is Venus. Very nude. I can see what I did when I bought these because I was like, lip liner, lip gloss. I'm married. So yes, this one's Venus to go with my end point. I'm sure that's like supposed to sound way cooler than I'm making it. But I am a Montana girl, so here we go. Now you know why. Now you know why I sound silly. Okay, there they are. They're all swatched. Wonder what kind of mess I can make now. So we could, yeah, you can blend it out with your finger. Blend them together. Very fun. So we're gonna use these. I'm grabbing a makeup wipe. We're gonna use them in this Amora look. So here we go. Here is now the Amora the Enchantress trial run for my cosplay. Let's become the Enchantress. And yes, there will be a costume change in the end. Alright, so I'm mainly going to be using this palette here. It's the Limelife by Alcone. And it's just got all of the colors that I'm going to need. It's got the taupey browns. It's got that pretty green in here. So yes, we are going to be using that. And let's get started. Where's my hair? I'm gonna go in with a Sigma Blending E25, and I am just going to, and I do have, let's start over. All right, so on my face right now, I have my primer, which is the Kat Von D Locket Primer. I have my Urban Decay 24 hour foundation and the 1.5. I'll put all that information. So I have my face base going.
Anastasia Beverly Hill brows, and I have some Limelife bronzer and some Limelife blush in I think number 6, and then my lip plumper. So that's really all I've done to my face is just the base, and now we're gonna do the eyes. So I'm gonna go in with this lighter white color here, I believe it's called Cream Boat. Just gonna tap my brush into that, and I'm gonna give myself the start of an even coat. Really? Stay. Okay. There we go. There we go. Nope, it's gonna fall again. This is not gonna work. Don't do it. Do not get the HAUS Laboratories liquid shadow liquid powder in your eye. Oh gosh, oh, that hurt. It's my fault though. I was totally careless. Okay. So I'm gonna do my lips now. Lippy lips. The lip lap. Like a spider. I'm gonna use this NYX Born to glow in Chosen One. There's some of it. That makes sense. That makes sense. And then I'm going to do my eyeliner and put on some lashes, and I'll demo the lashes, but the eyeliner I won't, because you should know how to put on some eyeliner. But this is my favorite eyeliner. It's Limelife. It's a brush tip, not a felt tip, so it goes on way better than any of the other ones that I have found. It's very like fine point. Compliments on how sharp my point is. That's why. Right there. Get that product. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, so I put my eyeliner on, but I'm going to be putting this Tori Belle Magnitude Magnetic Eyeliner on top of my liner. So I can use my magnetic. Two coats of that, which I already had one coat on, and then these are the Selfies, and I had to trim them because my eyes were a little bit smaller than the actual lash, and they're way easy because they're magnetic. You just pick it up and literally just pop it on. The liner dry, and then you place these magnetic lashes on top of the liner. So the liner has iron oxide in it, and that's what the magnets stick to, and it's completely safe for your eyes. them extra nice, because then you don't have a yucky glue mess, you don't have that extra like glue marks that can be a pain. Blah, 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 blah. That could be a pain. So there's the lashes. And I think I'm going to pop on some more of this gold onto my lips, because I kind of did that off camera and now it's fading. But I kind of liked it. Do it on the bottom too. Of course, I'm going to take pictures. Alrighty, here is the finished Amora look, and I will show you the rest of the costume. So here it is, guys, my Amora costume. I have the headdress and this cute leather corset dress. I have the black leggings and boots, and then these gloves. What I need to do is dye the gloves so they're more this color, and then get the gold belt that goes across here, and then make the gold circles that go down the pants, and then she's done for my first round of Amora, the Enchantress.